Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we are going to start our new class on the topic of mathematics M1. As you all know that mathematics is comprised of four components, and we are today discussing about the M1, which is known as mechanics 1. Okay, M1 is paper 4 of A level mathematics and it is known as mechanics 1. It is upon you that how you can choose it in AS or in A2. Now, as you all know that mechanics is related to the forces, you know that's the distance time graph, related to the speed, forces, and furthermore, the main subtopic of mechanics is about the resolving of the component. We all know that there are only two types of component that exist in the world. Now, one component is known as the horizontal component and other component is known as the vertical component. Okay, and only these two components exist in the world, and we have to convert the force or we have to just resolve the component only in these two components. Okay, horizontal component in the terms of physics or in the term of M1 is known as the cosine component, you can say that. Okay, and vertical is somehow known as the sine component. Okay, it is of y-axis. You all know that, while horizontal is of x-axis. There are some few tips and tricks that must be remembered in order to resolve the component. First of all, we all know that sine and cosine are both opposite of each other. For example, if I say that cosine angle 90 minus theta, okay, so equals to, for example, the answer is 56 degree. So it would be like as that sine 90 degree minus 56 equals to theta, okay. This is how you can understand how these two components exist. Okay, now we are just giving you some of the important tips regarding these two components, how to resolve this component and how this component exists. It may be very much clearful by the help of the diagrams. Okay, and if you are just going to search it in your book, so you may find it in a chapter 4. Okay, chapter 4 in your mechanics book. And chapter 4 is regarding the forces. Okay, forces chapter 4. It gives you a simple and basic introduction about the resolving of the forces or component. For example, if the force is exist, if a block, okay, and it is a force of 10 newton, and there is some another force which is of 5 newton, while the other force is of 20 newton. We all know that if we go with the resultant of the component, so it would be 20 minus 10 minus 5, and it would be as 20 minus 15, it would be 5 newton towards the left. This is a basic, you all know that how the component, and if somehow we are just going to a vertical component, we can draw it. So we have a separate diagram and we can solve it in a vertically as well. Okay. But a real problem or real issue, or you can say the main topic or main subtopics we are going to read in this book or in this chapter, is that if we are going to resolve the forces that are neither in the horizontal component or neither in the vertical component. For example, if a diagram, you can say that the car or a block and there is a force acting over there, it is of 10 newton, okay, and the angle it is of 25 degree, and we have to find its vertical component and its horizontal component. So vertical component and horizontal component are both unknown for us. Okay, it is because the force is neither in the horizontal nor in a vertical component. So we have to find it. We all know that vertical is known as a y-axis, or you can say it is sine component. So we'll be just writing as downward component, okay? And if we just go with the, we all know that force F equals to mg cos theta, or you can say that if we just solve it, so we'll be like as F equals to 10 newton, it is comes in the newton, and it would be multiplied with the cos 25, okay? Or you can say that, or you can say that F equals to 10 newton into, if it is a minus 90 minus 25, so it would be equals to 65, so it would be sine 65. Both the answer would be same, and somehow we will get a horizontal component. If we just going to solve its vertical component, so vertical component like as it is a horizontal component, okay, and for vertical component we can go with the, okay, for vertical component it would be as F equals to 10 into sine 25, or F equals to 10 into cosine 65. These both answers would be same, and these both answers would be same. By the help of this, we can get a horizontal component, as we know that we are solving it horizontally. Okay, you all know that. And it is somehow same, because as I already told you, that cosine 90 minus theta equals to sine theta. Okay, and hopefully you are getting this introduction regarding the mechanics one. And we are just going to solve 2 to 3 questions of the book, so it may help you to just start your studies before the starting of the new session or new classes, and it may really give you a good introduction and helps to have a knowledge before your proper classes. Okay, and we are just going to solving a question of the book, and inshallah this will help you to learn in a good manner. Because we all know that there are some of the important terms and important tips are given in the book as well, as these are very much important, and book reading is very much important regarding solving of the past question, because it all depends on your book. Okay, just an example, 4B example of your book. It is of my page number 39. Hope you have a same book like me. And there is a question that is given like question 1 of example 4B, and example 4B question 1 like, and a force is going with a 7 newton towards the top, and at right angle it would be going with a 8 newton, it is forming right angle, and there is a force regarding the, there is a 4 newton, and there is an angle it is forming which is of 60 degree. Okay, very much easy question, and they are asking to find the resultant of the force. We all know that all the forces must be go with a pure horizontal component and a pure vertical component. Then we are going to find a force that would be a resultant vector. Okay, first step, that first of all we are solving it horizontally. We all know that 7 is a vertical, is a pure vertical component, so 7 can't go as a horizontal component. And if we just go with the 7 cos 0, you may find an answer as a 0. And now 8 newton, if you are just solving horizontally, we are solving the question horizontally, and we will be getting 7 is not included, as we all know. First of all, 8 newton, okay. If the direction would be same of this force, so it would get plus. Also that there is a different direction, so we will be just minus 7. Or you can say that 8 newton equals to 4 newton 4 cos 60. And it will, okay, 8 minus 4 cos 60 equals to 0, and the answer will be fine. So we can write it as a horizontal component, or you can just write it as a resultant. Okay, horizontal resultant equals to 1. I don't have a calculator in my hand, so there would be an answer. You can find it, and it would be a horizontal component. Okay. Now we are just going to solve it as a vertical component. Vertically, we can solve it like as same as for horizontal component. Now A newton would not be included. It is in a pure horizontal component. It does not have any vertical component in it, and it would be 0. Okay. Now it's 7. If 7 equals to, if you just draw a line over there, and you know that it is 30, it forms a 90. So you can write 4 cos 30 or 4 sin 60. Okay. Now 7 minus a vertical resultant equals to 7 minus 4 cos 30. Okay. Now the question is not just solved. Now one step remaining in the question, and it is like as we all know that there would be a final answer. For example, answer is 20. Okay, 20 is the answer of the horizontal component, and vertical component it is of 25. Now we have to draw a resultant, and we all know that by help of hypotenuse square equals to perpendicular square plus base square, we can find the hypotenuse, and it would be our final answer. Okay, this is now we can solve the question related to the resultant question, and there are many questions regarding a solving of the component. Just we need to remember that how the force acts, and we have to clearly go with a pure vertical component or pure horizontal component. Okay, if there are many forces, etc., for example, there are force going as there, there's another force going as there. So we should all know that it must be go in a horizontal and it must go in a vertical, because these forces are neither in horizontal nor in a vertical component. Hopefully you enjoy our video, and it is just an introduction class of the mechanics 1, which is a chapter 4 regarding the resolving of the vertical and horizontal components. And inshallah we'll be working like as. Hopefully you subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon, and hopefully you are receiving our video on daily basis. Till now, Allah Hafiz.